Hi guys, welcome to Mishi Blue Tarot, welcome to my channel. This is Neelam and I'm back for all of you guys with another reading today. And today's topic is, what are your person's current thoughts and feelings towards you? Okay, and towards this connection, we will see what's gonna whatever we pick up from the cards. It had been a while that I did this, so I thought I'll do it today. Pardon the noise in the background because there's some construction work going on and I can't do anything about it. So I've picked crystals and then we will look into the cards about their feelings, their thoughts, emotions, and what should you do. We'll in fact look at advice also as to, you know, what you can do and how can you probably handle the situation better. So pile one is the Amethyst. Pile 2 is going to be the Pyrite. And pile 3 is the Rose Quartz. Okay? You can pause the video. Think about your person. Think about your situation. Also, one more point, guys. If you have any doubts in your mind that you want to clear through a reading. So before picking your piles, just think of that situation and think of the questions that you have in your mind. Your third eye chakra will intuitively obviously guide you to pick a pile through which you will get that answer. So you just need to be open and receptive. Okay, we'll begin with the Amethyst. These are my favorite bunch of crystals. All right, so whoever chose the Amethyst, let's see. What are your person's current thoughts and feelings? What are your person's current thoughts and feelings? Should I pick one more or not? I'm confused. Okay, this deck is pulling me. These are messages, so. I'll just pull out like two messages, which will just help us understand the state of mind, and then we'll look more into the cards. Okay, let's see, what are your person's current thoughts and feelings. Dry desert, three of wands. I believe we are meant to be together. I need you to need me like I need you. Okay, right off the bat, this connection, there is a distance. There is, I mean, when I say distance, either you guys are not communicating or you guys are communicating but very less communication. You both could be in sort of a stuck energy where things are not moving forward because one of you, and I think this is your person, who is not willing to take that leap of faith right now. Okay? Alright, so this reading seems to be like coming like a channeled message from this person. This person probably has taken a step back because they really, I mean, okay, this person is at this stage not wanting to be there like the way you want them to be because they feel that they haven't achieved enough in life. That's one major, major reason. This person feels that, you know, they want to be an achiever in life. And until then, I don't think this person wants to move forward at all. Till they know that, yes, you need them as much as they need you. Okay, now this is a little bit of an egocentric statement. People do not need each other in a relationship. They want each other and they want to be with each other. But this is how this person is thinking. And it's my duty to tell that to you. Now, I also feel that it's not like it's a very easy ride for this person to do this. They're quite alone. they do feel the pangs of loneliness because you're not around. It does hurt them. It's not like it's a very easy thing for this person to be the way they are currently. However, I feel that this person knows that there is hope. There is hope here and things can change for the good. Okay? I am not seeing that this person is given up on this connection. No. Okay? This person does feel that you will understand why they are doing this. Okay, there are sometimes we come across people who want you to wait, but in a very toxic way. This is not the vibe I'm getting from this pile. This is more of like, I know. It's like more of understanding between the two of you that yes, even if this situation requires waiting, it will happen. It is not like we don't understand each other. I don't know why I'm channeling this message. Like, you know, it's not like we don't understand each other or it's not like we don't care about each other. We do, but this distance is necessary so that, you know, I am capable enough to be with you. It's that kind of a message that I'm picking up. Okay. But yeah, you on the other hand, I'm seeing you feel very lost because you're not... Because yes, I mean, I'm also seeing that this person has not said anything to you. And you've just been left out. But I do feel this person will keep the communication on. It's not like this person will give up on communicating. So that there is one... hope. I mean, like, for you to understand that yes, they're not gone from this. Okay, let's see what else is this person currently thinking. Oh no, wait, let me use this deck. The Sun. King of Swords. The Fool, yeah. This person needs to also free themselves from something. Three of Swords. See, I told you. This person needs to work on themselves. Okay? And that is playing a huge role in this situation. It's not like it's a very easy thing for this person. Okay. I am seeing that nobody knows them the way you do. Okay? And this person is very much aware of this fact that you really understand them in and out. Now, even after all of this, they know that you become the reason for them to free themselves from something. What is this something? Let's see. What is the block here? Nine of Pentacles. For some of you, it could be financial problems. Yeah. I somehow feel this person is a little insecure that they do not match up to you. Yeah. They feel this, that they do not match up to you. And hence, I think this person really doesn't want to... be someone who's not worthy of you. They feel this way. This person wants to be in a relationship where they also feel equally with. I think you could be an achiever. You are someone who's very sorted in the mind and you just know what you want to do in your life. So I am seeing that this person really wants to make it happen with you. But when they also feel that they are ready and they are sure about themselves. Let's see if they are going to do something. Are they going to do something? The Devil. I knew that a devil will come. The Sun. Seven of Cups. Okay, yes, this person, as I said, you become the reason for this person's motivation in life. Okay, so definitely I'm seeing that this person will break the shackles of the past, let go of the karma scene that exists between the two of you. So when I say karma, it basically means two people who get connected karmically, it has a lot of lessons and a lot of things which you both trigger in each other. It's not going to be an easy ride. It's karmic for a reason. That's why. It's a lesson. And the more comfortable you become, the more easier it is for you. I am seeing that this person will not let this relationship break. The moment they see that it's something that is breaking, something's happening, this person will try to hold back. This person will try to not let this thing happen. I am also seeing that they have this clarity that the happiness that they've been looking for in their life, it lies here. But it requires them to change, to completely change and transform. And that's, I think, what they're working towards. And you become the reason why they work on this. So what they are going to do is, I have a feeling that this person might tell you that They'll not let this connection go for sure, but I'm not actually picking up a very aggressive move that they're going to make, like very aggressively pursue you or something. No, nothing like that. I'm seeing that they're going to make sure that this relationship stays because they value your presence in their life. That is very sure. This person values what they have with you. This person doesn't want to let go of that at any cost. Also seeing that the attraction or the chemistry is very strong because that is what is pushing them to make it happen. That's what I'm seeing. What's the advice for you in it? Now let's see, this is the last part of the reading. What's the advice or what's in it for you? King of Pentacles, Seven of Swords. One sec, I'll tell you what it means. Okay, this person's energy can be really hooking, by the way. Like, as in, it will be very difficult for you to get yourself out of that energy because I feel that this person has made a huge mark in your life. And that's how they, I mean, that's what they feel. It's funny, but that's what they feel happy about, that at least you two think about them and this person knows it. There's a very strong karmic connection between the two of you. But you have to understand and accept this in a very mature way that yes, the connection exists, but there is a reason why it's not happening right now or it's not meant to happen, whatever it is, you need to focus on building your own empire, like whatever you are doing right now, whatever makes you happy, whatever you wanted to make yourself happy. So basically what I'm seeing is that the memories of the past can throw itself on you. You just need to understand how to deal with it. I mean, I really can't give you a very clear-cut answer here because you guys will not be able to completely snap out of it and such. It was a bond that was meant to come so that both of you become aware of aware of your own self. And forgetting a connection like this is not easy. So yeah, that's what I'm picking up for you guys. Pile one. I hope this reading helps. Private readings are open, so you can reach out to me. And let me know in the comments if this reading resonated. Alright guys, take care. Talk to you soon. Bye-bye. Okay, let's look at pyrite now. Today's reading, the energy seems very interesting. So whoever chose this stone, let's see what are your person's current thoughts and feelings for you. Pile one became a little detailed. So let's see what is the detailing that we pick over here. Just wants to fly out, so we take it. Okay, let's see. What are your person's current thoughts and feelings for you? Coming to life, King of Wands. I didn't mean to hurt you, I want to take a trip with you. Okay. This person is not going to give up. Okay. This pile, what I'm picking up is that maybe you are resisting this person. Maybe you are not... You guys have a love-hate kind of a relationship. I don't know how many of you are resonating with it, but whoever is, please comment. This person is constantly charmed by what you do or who you are. You ignite a certain part of this person's personality that they feel that they've not seen someone like you. You guys could be having a lot of arguments, and those are constructive arguments that help you become better in life. Okay, if you guys have had some kind of an argument, which you probably stood up for yourself and you just kind of took a step back, this person has a message that they didn't mean to hurt you. But if they did, you would know I'm not here to convince you for anything. But this person is going to fix things. This person is not going to give up on this connection. I'm seeing that this person would want to make sure that things become fine again. Now, when I look at this card, this person is probably strategizing something. I think slowly this person will understand and they will try to approach you very slowly. It's not going to be a very, trying to push themselves on you, no. But they know you very well and they like you for who you are, like the way you are. So this person is going to not give up on you. Basically, that's one. It just seems like a channel message. This person is not willing to give up on you at all. And they really want to fix things. And for that, if it requires them to spend time with you, they will. But let's see, what else are their feelings for you currently? Death. Three of Cups. Ace of Cups. Ten of Pentacles. Page of Pentacles. I knew it. You've changed this person. This person wants to now do things in the right way, the way you wanted it. You've ignited emotions in this person. They did not expect this to happen, but you have. This person is now looking at, you've changed this person 360 degree, and that is what death card symbolizes. It's like, in fact, today. Today is 22nd of July, right? And this is card number 4. 2 plus 2 is 4. So the change is happening right now as we speak. Okay, this person is really wishing, okay, that they could probably make this happen once again. And I do see this person strategizing. I do have a feeling this person will reach out to you the day when the time is right and when they can tell you that, okay, this is the way forward. Yeah, Three of Wands. I think this person is just waiting for the right time to come towards you. Now, I don't know. So, when is the right time? Let's see that. What is the right time and when is the right time? It's not yet come. But they are aware of what they feel for you. This I can see. They know that you both fit in really well with each other. They want to heal themselves first. Like, I have a feeling this person has done a lot of nasty things in their life. And you've come up, you came and this person just started to realize how pathetic they've been. I'm so sorry, but that's what I'm picking up from the energy. And it's like they feel... All this while, this person felt that they had so much or they were so good, but suddenly this person now feels that they're nothing. So they want to feel worthy again and then be with you. I think that's the pause they are taking to just make sure that, I think in the Virgo season, so that's September, I feel this person will make the necessary moves that is needed. They're working on healing themselves right now. They hadn't expected this thing to happen though. But yeah, that's what I'm seeing. But now let's see. Will they do something? The tower. Oh my god. They are unsure if you will accept them. I feel the moment you said something or something happened between the two of you is when this person realized how much love they had for you. And probably you've shut yourself off. You don't want to talk. You don't want to communicate again. You don't want to say anything again. But this person is unsure if, they're not giving up, but they are unsure if, would you accept them? Would you let them in? That's where this person is currently. Now, let's see. What's the advice for you here? Six of Wands, Hermit. The Lovers. The Empress. Okay. You're the one at power over here. The choice is yours. Take your time and think if you want to entertain this person at all in your life. This person will always give you preference over everything else. It's not like they, because they've not felt the way they felt with you. Now, the whole point is the choice is open to you. Now, I don't know, you might be having your own reasons for not accepting this in your life. But then you're the Empress or you're the Emperor, gender doesn't matter. You can decide what you want to do with this connection. Like if you want, this connection can happen. But if you want and you want to hold grudge and you don't want to, like whatever happened in the past is too much for you to deal with, if you feel, then you can just let this go. You don't really need to worry or panic about it. That is what I'm picking up from the cards. All right, pile two, that's what I have. I hope this reading helped. Private readings are open so you can reach out to me and let me know in the comments if this resonated with you. Okay, it's a pretty interesting reading, pile number three. Can be very specific also. So take care and I shall talk to you guys soon. Bye bye. Okay, we will now move to file number 3. Okay, whoever chose the Rose Quartz Rock, this is your pile. Let's see, what are your person's current thoughts and feelings for you? Person's current thoughts and feelings for you. Okay, so I'm going to take this because I was shuffling and this fell out unexpectedly and the card is unexpected visitor. Let's keep it. I'm not picking anything else. Let me pick the other cards. Your person's current thoughts and feelings. Pile number 3, Rose Quartz. Your person's current thoughts and feelings, pile 3. Okay. Let's see. 10 of Swords. I'm scared of losing you. Oh, I'm so embarrassed over my actions. Okay. Firstly, this person is keeping a very close watch on what you're doing. Okay. This person wants to know every bit of a detail of what you're doing, and you never know the sources through which this person knows what's happening with you. Okay, this person could be really wanting a chance to talk to you, okay? But maybe you're not giving them that chance. Maybe this person is... They're tired of trying. I don't know, have they tried to reach out to you a number of times or have they tried to explain themselves and you didn't listen? And if you feel the try is very less, then for them that try is a lot, okay? That's what I'm seeing. And that's how he or she is thinking, okay? This person is right now looking for opportunities or ways through which they can probably come forward and put across what I think both of you could be stalking each other somewhere. I don't know. Let me know in the comments. I'm seeing that both of you are just interested in what's going on in each other's life, but you don't want to bring it in front. Okay? This person, on the other hand, yes, they're scared of losing you. And whatever they did, they are very, very repentful about that whole thing. So it's not like it's easy for them. It's not like that. But they just don't know how to come forward and tell you that yes, what they did and however they did, they understand that it wasn't the right way of doing things. Let's see what else. Strength. King of Pentacles. There's a lot of ego battle going on. Wheel of Fortune. Five of Pentacles, yes. Between the two of you, I think there is a lot of ego clash that happens. This, you know your own, like I'm seeing strong masculine feminine energies, both at a very, at their own power kind of positions where they just do not want to listen to anything else. Okay, I'm also seeing that because there was ego clash, I think that you pulled yourself back and you wanted to win. I'm seeing this feeling in this pile that you guys have a lot of winning, losing, not letting this one win. I will win. That feeling come a lot between the two of you, and which is why I think you both are just away from each other. I think both of you have feelings, and I don't know, that's the message that I'm getting, and I should put this across that majorly, it's like if the ego battle ends, I think you both can be together. You kind of turned the wheel, or maybe that person, okay? One of you turned the wheel and just ended everything and like, you know, no, this is unacceptable. This is not something that I'm going to tolerate at all. And then the clash happens. I am seeing that both of you miss each other. Oops. Both of you miss each other, but the ego comes in between and it becomes very difficult. So I'll tell you what, this person wants, it's like they've tried and they've failed so many times that now they're scared of trying also. Even though they know that yes, they've made certain mistakes, but still, I mean, for them, it's like maybe they've done this always and they've been forgiven. And that's why it's so difficult for them to understand that how should I deal with this whole situation? What should I do so that, you know, this problem doesn't happen? Okay, now let's see. Are they going to do something? Oh, I have three cards. Yes, yes, yes. All of them are yes. This person will try to reach out. This person will want a reconciliation with you. And I think around the month of November is what I'm picking up. That this person will want to communicate. And they would want to have a fresh start with you. They will not waste time thinking that nothing's happening. Should I not? Around November, they will again have the courage to pursue this again, because I'm seeing that this person also has the clarity that there's nothing but just ego coming in between the two of you. They do have this very clear picture in their head that yes, that's the only problem. Otherwise, there is no other problem between the two of you. It's more of like you both have a connection, and it's like you both are quite similar in a lot of ways, and you both have just confronted each other for the first time in your life, and then now it's like, oh my God, like how to deal with this, what to do, how to do it, all of these things that, you know, it's like you're facing each other's mirror images, and then becomes difficult to deal with your own weaknesses, because that's what you see in the other person when you are with somebody, and those are the same weaknesses that you have. So this is a very strongly spiritually connected connection where you're seeing yourself. Okay? Now let's see what's in it for you. What is the advice for you in this situation? Seven of Swords. I'll tell you the meaning. The Magician and the Knight of Pentacles. Okay. I think the memories will play a huge role here. The memories that the two of you have is going to push you both to make or create the new beginning that you both are looking for. That is what I'm seeing, that these memories will only kind of act as a vehicle or a medium because of which one of you will, both of you will not be able to let go one, and I think this person will only reach out, but in a very slow and steady way. It will take time, but I think this person will, because I think somewhere your shadow sides connect very strongly, and you know that if this person is speaking about their weakness, it is actually true. This is their weakness. That is what I'm picking up from the cards. Okay, pile 3, that's what I have. I hope this reading helps. Private readings are open, so you can reach out to me and let me know if this reading resonated with you guys. Okay, take care. Bye-bye.